Patrick and I were fortunate enough to be brought on board at Saw 4, and when we were conceiving the first plot for Saw 4, we thought through a few chapters beyond that, just so if there was to be a question or an unanswered detail of the plot, that there would be soil to mine in the future. That helped the fabric of the series kind of keep fresh and keep moving and have a velocity that seemed organic, rather than open, shut, boom, done, and then always be painted into a corner. The nice thing about the fractured timeline of a Saw film is you get to reach from the past, the present, and, you know, maybe even the future at some point to continue fleshing out this. You know, really, really fortunate and fantastic franchise. Trap concepts come from every different angle. It's and sometimes it comes from an angry altercation someone had and they just figured out what they'd like to do to that person, all the way up to, well, you know, here's something we've been trying to figure out how to do for the past few years and I think we finally got it. Every working part of the entire production must come together to make these traps work. And it takes a hell of a lot of imagination on every level, from production to design and ultimately the direction, to make those moments sing. And really, it's a team effort to put those down. It's not just, you know, because you have to think, well, this has to be something somebody could have built. This has to be something that will work on the audience, and it has to be something we haven't seen before. Well, now, 7 movies and approximately 45 traps in, you know, we got to stay sharp. It has been a wonderful experience to work alongside Tobin Bell, because he brings so much to the character of John Kramer and Jigsaw. It's as if that the more human he's able to make John Kramer, the more frightening the Jigsaw character becomes. Jigsaw is a tape and a disembodied voice more often, but it's his portrayal of that human being. It's the philosophy behind it, and it's that Tobin has given every fiber of his being to creating a character that can sustain beyond death. I mean, this is somebody that passed away 4 films ago and still is as, you know, vital to the progression of every story as if he was alive and the lead character. It speaks volumes to Tobin's passion and dedication to this series that character is such a landmark. We have a new horror icon with Jigsaw that stands proud next to Michael Myers, Jason, Freddy, and Pinhead. Saw 6 was a great thrill to work on, because we were able to provide, I think, a story, and Kevin's direction provided a film that felt complete, and it answered some questions from the past and answered enough in the present. So if you were to walk away from that film, you were satisfied, but yet it did leave a few open doors for 7. 7 is the same, it's the same goal, in that we want to give you a bigger, wild experience, and yet reach even further into the past, maybe answer a few more things, have a sense of satisfaction by the time the lights come up, and yet, you know, should we be so fortunate as to return to this story in the future, there will always be an open door as long as there's the imagination to think of it. This October, when fans of the Saw series come to the theater, they will be granted an experience not unlike any other. I think that there's a few images and a few moments in this that are entirely brutally unique. I should probably start apologizing to my parents now, but I can't wait to see it.